Hello and welcome to the video. In the previous video, I'll show how you could make the wings of the Hawker Hurricane with a HotWire CNC machine using ProFili Pro2. I'll put a link in the description if you want to have a look at that one. This video goes on to show how to make the fuselage sections with a program called DevFus Foam, again using the four-axis CNC machine. Before you attempt to do this, you'll need a good three-view drawing. The drawings can be in either DXF format, CAD format, or JPEG, PNG. But what you'll need to do is cut out the side view and the top view, and then these can be imported into DevFus Foam and then used to create the outlines that will eventually generate all the various formers. Right, so now we're in DevFus Foam, and rather than show a complete new project, I'll show you my Hawker Hurricane. First thing you have to do is specify the actual length and the width and height. So these you'll decide from your drawings of how big you want the aircraft to be. Then on this page here, you're able to import the images for the top view and the side view. And then what you also do is once you've got that in, you specify the length. Then DevFus Foam will create these outlines. But what you can do, you can then go in and alter the outlines with control points to get them closer to the drawing. It does take a little while to get used to, but once you get the hang of it works quite well. Yeah, so once you've got that done, then you go on to the next section. And this is where it's created all the formers. There are a couple of extra little steps when you do a new project that asks you for the size of the foam, but when you're modifying one, the size is already there. So you can then go in and edit all the formers if they're not quite as you want or not in the right position. So you can actually move a former if you want to. So over here we're just demonstrate moving one if it's not quite in the right position. And then you can actually go in then, and if the actual form was not quite the right shape, you can go in and edit the actual former itself. And you can add extra control points and move things around. So this isn't really a tutorial on how to use DevFus Foam, it's more of a demonstration really. It's taken me quite some time to understand how to use it properly. Right, so once we've done that and we're happy with all the formers and their positions, we then go on to the next section. And this is if you want to put any sheeting around the, so you might want to put a thin veneer over it. This section here, you can add some spars down the fuselage. These can be quite useful for lining all the fuselage parts up once you've created them, because you'll end up with lots of little fuselage parts that will need aligning and joining. So if you've got this spar going down either the top or bottom of the fuselage, it can aid with alignment. So I'm just going to add one here along the top. And in most cases, I've just accepted the default settings. So we've now got the spar in there. Next section, we go on to adding lightning holes. So at the moment, it's all that's going to happen is you'll just have a solid piece of foam. But what you can do, you can apply lightning holes to either all the pieces or just a few of the pieces. So I normally leave the tail section without any lightning holes, because by the time you get to the tail section, the pieces are getting quite small anyway. So in this example here, I've just removed the last two pieces from lightning holes, and you can alter the actual thickness of the lightning holes, which then gives you the thickness of the whole fuselage. I think I normally left it a half an inch or sort of 12.5 mil, but just for this demo I've just changed it to 3.75. And then apply. So the 16 formers, but we're going to only apply it to the first 14 formers. Yeah, nearly forgot to do it then. And there we go. It adds the lightning holes. And you can see the last two there don't have any lightning holes on them. And you can also see the spar at the on the top section there. So now you can actually have a look at what they would look like in 3D to give you some idea if it looks okay. So you can spin it round, and yeah, it does sort of look like a hawk hurricane. And then you can come out, have a look at the spars and formers. If you spin this round, you can actually see down through the fuselage as well to see what it would actually look like inside. And then the last one just shows you the actual number of blocks that would be created. So these are all the individual pieces that would then be produced by the 4-axis CNC machine. It does take a little while to get to understand how it works, but it's worth the effort in the end. So now once we've got that, then we can go into cut fuselage blocks. Well, not actually cutting them, we're generating the code, which we can then send to the CNC machine. Now you won't be able to cut them all at once because there's just too many of them, unless you've got a really big machine. I normally manage to get about 2 to 3. So here I'm just selecting the first 3. And then we're on the wizard to generate the G code. So these are the first 3 we're going to create. A majority of the settings I just leave at default. They seem to work quite well. I And then on to the next section. And this is the kerf setting. This is the amount of foam that's going to be melted away by the hot wire running through. So you can alter the value of that. Then here, this section here, probably the most important one here, is to test the path limits. Because what you quite often find, if you've got any parts that have quite a slope on them, you might not have enough travel on your CNC machine to actually make them parts, so you have to bring the two towers of your CNC machine very close together. As you can see here, this is the simulation. And you can run this through to just give you some idea of what's going to happen. For some reason, this always goes backwards for me. I don't know whether I'm doing something wrong. But it starts off on the last bit and then goes. So actually what it would do, as we'll see later, it actually does the inside part first and then comes and does the outer part next. But it can be useful to check if things are going as you expected. Right, then we come out of that. This is just about where to place the foam block. I generally don't do very much of this one, just leave it as it is. And the next section here is where we actually DevFus generates the code. One of the things to make sure of is that if you've got your axis correct, I use Mach 3, and you need to use X, Y, A, and Z. So when we click on OK now, it's actually going to generate the code. And here I'll save it. I'm just going to save it for the desktop. And then normally what I do is put in a USB drive and then take that to my actual CNC machine, which is running Windows XP, because it doesn't need anything very powerful. And once we've done, we should be able to have a look at the actual code. So this is the actual G code that DevFus Foam has produced, and this is what we'll send to the CNC machine. Right, so here it is loaded up into Mach 3. Now you get a representation of what it is, but because it's four axis, it doesn't display very well. And this example here is the pieces that we're cutting. So off it goes, and it is quite a slow process, so what I've actually done is speeded the video up by 20 times. But it does do quite a nice job. So it does the inner section first. And then once it's completed that inner section, then you've got the outer section. You do need to have a lot of foam when you're doing this, because you'll end up wasting a lot of pieces with practicing. And I mean, I've gone through sheets of foam.
Right, here's the results of DevFus cutting out the formers. So we've got F1, F2 and F3 there. As you can see, they go together quite well. Start to form the nose section of the Hurricane. These were a couple of test pieces I did earlier. As you can see, they didn't come out so well. There was too much heat on them and it was melting the foam away. Whereas these pieces are coming out, have come out a hell of a lot better. So just 13 more pieces to make. And there's the remains of the foam block. What I found the best way to do this is to actually stick the blocks down on the boards with a double-sided tape. And it's quite solid and it means you're not having extra weights on top and it makes it look a bit unstable.
As of November 2016, I still haven't got the Hurricane finished yet. I've had quite a busy year with one thing and another, but I, as you can see from the picture, it's getting there, and I hope to have it flying early next year. Hope that's been interesting for you, and you know, if you need any more information, just have a look at the website, where there's other videos there as well on the CNC machine. Thanks for watching.